Quickbase recently launched a mobile app for Apple and Android phones. It has several new features that you'll want to check out. Welcome to Quickbase Junkie. I help Quickbase builders learn fast to deliver more. Using Quickbase away from the office is getting easier and easier. Now with geolocation, easy photo upload, dictation, and other features that I'm excited to share with you. I'm using an iPhone, so I'll get the app from the App Store. All right, let's check out that app. Looks like you can use Face ID and other biometrics. I'm going to skip that for now. And I can see my apps. I'm going to use the Complete Project Manager from the Quickbase App Exchange to show you some of these features. Here I'm on the mobile version of the homepage. Includes links to various reports, some buttons to create new items, as well as various charts and reports. Let's go first into the customers table. I'll open a record and view an address. So one of the features is the mapping. So if I click this little button here on the right, it'll open my maps and show me that address. Pretty snazzy if you're on the road. Head back to the application. Let's say I want to create a new record. I'll go to the home page in this app. Back at the top, I can hit the little plus icon, create a new record. Let's try the geolocation, another feature of the mobile device. Now, this isn't my actual address, but it did populate, and I assure you it was fairly accurate. Let's look at the photo and attachments feature. Cancel, head back to my main navigation menu, and open the expenses table. I'm going to edit an existing expense. On the expense record here, there is a space for a file attachment for a receipt. Clicking on that, I can take a new photo, or I can access my photo library, or browse to another file. Let's see about taking a new photo. Now it's not a receipt, but you can imagine taking a picture of a receipt or damage to a vehicle or pictures of different phases of a construction site, anything you like, and save it directly to the record. That feature I like. I edit this record again, and in the notes here, I can also dictate my notes instead of typing them in, which is much easier on the phone. Please find the receipt attached. That was really easy. Save that record, and everything's populated, the receipt and the text. Something else here on the bottom, there's a little bullhorn where you can send feedback to Quickbase on how the app is working for you. So send them any feedback if you run into any issues or find certain features that you like. I'm sure they want to hear about those. Let's look at some of the reports. So to access the reports, we can see them on the right-hand side here along with each of our tables. Go into the tasks report list. You can see there's a variety of different types of reports. Table reports like these, bubble reports, calendars, and even Kanban reports. This one's a little bit interesting. My screen resolution has shrunk a bit in order to fit the Kanbans on here. I can't actually scroll left to right, but when I pick up a card ever so gently, I can move that card across the different phases and then drop it into a new phase. This isn't very easy, so I don't know what Quickbase might be doing about that, especially since I can't move from left to right just to view. I have to pick up a card in order for it to move, but I'm sure that's something they are working to improve. Perhaps I'll send something through that feedback button. Some of the reports, however, I cannot access on the mobile device. It tells me I have to go to the full site in order to see that report. There also isn't an option to create anything through the app. This is really more of a view and edit only, no admin settings per se. There is a settings button down here in the bottom right corner that's only for my sign-in info. So I'm not going to open that one up right now. If I head back into the main menu, you can see I can access all of my apps, the app homepage for the app I'm currently on, go into the items I've recently viewed, and then of course access all of these tables and reports that I've shown you. There's also an option to search here at the top. So that search works pretty great, searching across the various tasks in this case, and I can choose to search across other items as well. I did see in the messaging that Quickbase sent out with their announcement today that there will be mobile-friendly forms. I have not yet seen those in the desktop version. It's where I believe admins will be able to go in and create mobile-focused forms that will be available only through the mobile app version as opposed to the desktop version. I don't see that option yet, but I'm sure it's coming. And I heard when I was at Empower last year, there might be barcode reading and possibly even signature capture coming on the mobile device, because those things will come in super handy and it's great to be able to capture things like that through the mobile device. That's some of my first impressions of the new Quickbase mobile app. I'd love to hear your thoughts as well. Go ahead and comment below. If you learned something new, please like this video. And to get your regular Quickbase Junkie fix, subscribe to Quickbase Junkie on YouTube or visit QuickbaseJunkie.com.